translation. With the rays of the two Brahmastras combined, a great circle of fire from the sun covers all outer space, the whole firmament of planets. Vishwa,
Krishna,
Nasim,
Nasim,
Astra,
Astra,
weapon.
Weapon.
Translation. All the population of the three worlds was scorched by the combined heat of the weapons. Everyone was reminded of the Samvartaka fire, which takes place at the time of annihilation.
Sanghatya Anandam Ubhaya Tejasi Sarasangvite Avritya Rodasi Khancha Babridhati Atkaman Vak Drishta Satejasastu Tayo Silokan Pradhan Mahat Dayamana Prajasarva Sangvartaka Amangsaka. So the heat increased, radiation heat increased. One weapon was released by Ashwatthama, another by Arjuna to counteract. And the heat was so terrible that Dayamana Praja Sarva, all the inhabitants of different planets, they felt the great heat produced by two Brahmastra. And Sangvartakam Amangsaka. The Sangvartaka fire is explained in the Shastra that in the Kali Yuga, at the last there will be Kali Yuga, in the Kali Yuga there will be no rainfall, so everything will dry, not this Kali Yuga, but at the end of the universal life, there will be great fire. All over the universe. That is called Sangvartaka. And everything will be ablaze. This fire will take place on account of the heat increase of the sun. It is said that the present temperature of the sun will be increased 12 times. So naturally there will be fire. As we know, sometimes there is forest fire. Similarly, the fire will take place and everything will be burned into ashes. Then there will be rain. After heat, you have got experience. When the atmosphere is too hot, then the rain falls. Same process. When everything will be burned into ashes, there will be rain, torrents of rain, and it is said, just like the trunk of the elephant, the rainfall will be like that. So everything will be covered with water. That is annihilation. Pralaya paya dhijale dhita vanasi vedam. Then there will be pralaya, and by the grace of the Lord, the Vedas will be saved. Keshava dhita meena sarira jaya jagadisha hari. This is the process. Going on, bhutta bhutta praliyate. This material world, in this way, sometimes it is manifested and sometimes it is not manifested. The energy is there, but the material world means the energy is sometimes manifested, sometimes not manifested. So we are in this material world. Not only we are changing our body one after another, after some years, that is also according to our different forms of life. In one small insect, it may live for few minutes, some of them for few hours, some of them for few days, and some of them for few months, some of them for few years. And this yearly, we human beings, we live for 100 years. And the demigods, they live for 10,000 years. But wherever you live, either as insect or as demigod, there is no rescue from the process of janma-mrityu-jara-vyadhi. That you cannot escape. Either you become a small insect or you become as powerful as Lord Brahma. You have to die. There is no escape. Brahma, he has the greatest amount of years to live. And his life is, we have calculation in the Bhagavad Gita, that sahasra yuga paryantam arhajyat brahmano vidu. Sahasra yugam, one yuga means 43 lakhs of years. Multiply it by 1,000. That is the one daytime duration of Brahma. Arhat means morning to evening. Morning to evening, that is sahasra yuga. 1,000 times of 43 lakhs of years. Similarly, night, then day and night becomes one day. Similarly, 1 month, and then 12 months, year, such 100 years. So, there is difference between our 100 years and his 100 years. Similarly, ants 100 years and my 100 years depend. The modern science admits that everything is relative. Relative world. According to the body, according to the time, relative world, not absolute. The absolute world is different, when there is no relativity. Everyone is as good as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That is oneness. Not that one has become as powerful as the Supreme Lord. No. Maybe as powerful, still they are individual. They are not amalgamation. That is wrong theory. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita that in the past we are all individuals. He says that it is not that in the past we did not exist, and it is not that in the future we shall not exist. We shall exist. Nitta sasatayam na hannati hannamani sarire. So, we are eternal. We existed in the past, we are existing now, and we shall continue to exist. And individual. Krishna says, you, me, and all the soldiers and kings, they are all individual. And they existed as individual in the past. And we are existing now as individuals. And we shall continue to exist as individuals. There are three phases of time, past, present and future. So there is no question of being amalgamated at any time. They remain all as individual. And this is in the material, either material world or spiritual world. The individuality is there. It never ceases. Nitya yukto upasat. Here we have got temporary life. Therefore, we cannot be nitya yukto. This life will be finished. And the next life, we do not know what kind of life we shall have. It may be human form of life, or it may be dog's form of life. We have to change this body. Tatha dehantara prati. Krishna does not say that a man after death becomes a man. No. There is no guarantee. He says tatha dehantara prati. There will be change of body. And so far the body is concerned, there are 8,400,000 of different bodies. So any one of them you have to accept. There is no guarantee. Tatha dehantara prati. So I, as spirit soul, am individual, existing. I shall continue to exist as individual in this material world, either as human being or as an animal or as demigod, as tree, plants, fish, aquatics, so many. Jalajana valakhani sthavara lakhavinsati. This is going on. This is material world. And if you go to the spiritual world, jadgatyana nivartante taddhamam paramam mama. The difference, what is the difference between the spiritual world and the material world? The difference is that if you go to the spiritual world, then you will not return again in this material world. Takta dehang punarjanmanaiti. Spiritual life means punarjanmanaiti. Punarjanma means this material world. Bhutta bhutta praliyat. One janma, then death, again janma, again death. And between this death and birth, or birth and death, there is disease and old age. Janma mitu jara vyadhi dukkha. This is our real problem. So the modern scientists, they do not know what is real problem. They are thinking advancement. Another point is here that trin lokan pradhan maha and dajmana praja sarva. Praja means living entities. Prajayate, when he takes his birth. So, in the three worlds mean this upper, middle and lower planetary system in this universe. Trilokan. So, everywhere there is praja, there is living entities. Otherwise, how it is said? Trilokan. It is a foolish theory that there is no life in other planets. There is self-fear. It is no meaning. Trim loka. We have got many evidences. I do not know why these rascal scientists say that there is no life in other planet. Why? The other planet is also made of the Panchabhut, Kiti Aptej Marudbao. They are not different. Maybe something is very prominent, just like in the sun glow, the fire is prominent. Fire is also one of the five elements. Kiti apteja. That does not mean there is no life. There must be. Otherwise, how Krishna talked with the sun god? Imam vivasati yugam praktavan aham abhayam. And the living entity Rayam Dahati Pavaka. The living entity is not burned by the fire. It is not dried up. It is not moistened. This is stated. So why there will be no life in the sun glow? There must be. Because na dahati pavaka. Fire cannot burn the living being. So, there are germs in the fire also, Agni Pok. So, we are being misled by the so-called scientists and the medicine. That is not perfect knowledge. The perfect knowledge is in the Vedas. Therefore, it is advised tad vijnanartha guru meva vigacche srotriyam brahmanishtha. You should go to a guru who has complete knowledge from the Shruti. Shruti means Vedas. Acharyamana purusha Veda. Veda means you have to approach Acharya. He knows everything. Unless he is not followers of the Vedas, Shruti, he is a rascal. What is the use of going there? What you will get by approaching a so-called rascal guru? One who does not know Shruti. Therefore, Srila Rupa Goswami has forbidden. And Sanatana Goswami has forbidden. Avaishnava mukhadgi na puta hari kathamritam sravanam na kattabham. Because sravanam, shruti, to go to guru means to hear from him, to inquire from him. Tad vijnanartham sa guru meva vigacche samitpani srotiyam brahmanishtha. You have to approach such guru. And who is that guru? Vaishnava, not any honors. Therefore, anyone who is not Vaishnava, you should not approach. It is false knowledge. Its knowledge has no value. Sanatana Goswami has strictly forbidden avaishnava mukhadgina puja hari kathamritam sravanam na kartam. Don't hear. It will be spoiled. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has said, Mayavadi bhasya sunile hoy sarvanash. If you hear from a Mayavadi, impersonalist, then your spiritual progress is doomed, finished. No more spiritual progress. Mayavadi bhasya sunile. Mayavadi hoy krishne aporadhi. The Mayavadi, they are offenders to Krishna. Krishna is the supreme person, and the Mayavadi wants to make him impersonal. Therefore, they are offenders. So, what is the use of approaching a guru who is offended to Krishna? Tarahang disata kuran, chipami ajasan dijunish. Those who are envious, Krishna is Satchidananda Vigraha, and the Mayavadi is always trying to make him a handless, legless, headless, earless, and thisless, thatless, less, then what is remaining? Say, zero. Why don't you say zero? No. They're very careful. These Sunnavadi, the Buddhists, they clearly say there is no God. It's zero. Sunnavadi. So we can understand their position. And the Mayavadis, they're so dangerous that they will not say the God is zero. They will say, yes, there is God. But he is handless, legless, eyeless, thisless, lessness, thatness. What is the meaning? Say zero, we can understand. But why you say indirectly zero? Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has said that Vedana Maniya Bodha Haila Nastik. Nastik means one who does not believe in the statement of the Vedas. He is Nastik. Atheist, just like here in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Krishna is person. This is basic literature, Bhagavad Gita. Krishna is person, aham. Always he says, aham yadi devana, manvana bhavamad bhakta, madhyaji magnamas kuru, sarvadhanman parittaji. He is person. So, the Mayavadi will always try to explain in the impersonal way. Therefore, they are offended. Krishna personally present. Why Krishna comes? So that the misunderstanding whether the absolute truth, God, is a person or impersonal, to mitigate this trouble, this misunderstanding, he comes as person. He presents himself, here is I am person. Why do you make me impersonal? He is person. Yada yada hi dharma saglani bhavati. Why you are taking so much trouble? Abhaktya sattva chetu sam, klesha adhikataraste sam. Simply you are taking unnecessary trouble. Klesha adhikata. And if you take to bhakti directly personal, and you cannot understand God or Krishna by any other means except bhakti. Bhaktya mama vijanati javana jaschami tata. If you want to know absolute truth, God, then you have to take to bhakti. And what does it mean, bhakti? Bhakti means there must be Bhagavan. And what is the meaning of bhakti? If I want bhakti means to render service. So, if the master is not there, then where is the question of bhakti and service? It's all bogus. Bhakti means three things. Bhakta, Bhagavan, and the service. That is bhakti. They are individual. Bhagavan is individual, bhakta is individual, and the reciprocation of dealing between two individuals, it is called bhakti. That is bhakti. Bhakti is described in so many places. Just like Rupa Goswami defines bhakti. Anna vilasita sunnam jnana karmadana britam anukullena krishnanu silanam bhakti ruttama. That is first class bhakti. And bhakti means there is activity. Anukullena, favorably. Krishnanusiranam, to satisfy Krishna. Anusilanam means culture. Culture means there is activity. Bhakti does not mean zero. That is another thing. Zero nirvana means make this material activities zero. That hint is given by Shankaracharya. Lord Buddha said that everything is zero, and Shankaracharya gave further improvement that it is not zero. Brahma is fact, Brahma Satya, not zero. Jagat Mithya, this world is Mithya, zero, not Brahma. Because those who understood this zero philosophy, the rascals, atheists, they cannot understand more. Therefore, further improvement was given by Shankara, because he was preaching. The whole world became Buddhist, and he wanted to establish Vedic principles. So they have already made zero. So how Shankaracharya can say, no, it is not zero, it is fact? They did not understand. He said in a different way that zero is this material one, Brahma Satya, but Brahma is fact. This is zero. Now how the fact is working, that is given by the Vaishnava Acharyas, especially Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Śrīmad-Bhāgavatam dharma prodhita akvaita bhavata. Dharma artha ka moksha. All cheating. Up to moksha. The aspiration to become one with the Supreme, moksha. And that is akvaita bhavata, cheating. That is the beginning of Śrīmad-Bhāgavatam. When you understand that the so-called monism, to become one with the Supreme, that is cheating. That is not fact. Because you cannot remain in the zero. That is not possible. We are part and parcel of God. God is Anandamaya. Anandamaya Mabhyasa. By nature, God is Anandamaya. So if you are part and parcel of God, how you can be nirānandamāya? You are also ānandamāya. That quality is there. But do you enjoy alone? You sit down in a room alone for 3 hours, you will feel disturbed. Immediately. And what to speak of eternally. It is impossible to remain alone. And for want of ananda, you will again fall down in this material world. The impersonalist who thinks that I become one with the Supreme. The one with the Supreme means that is eternity, fact. Sat, chit, ananda. Simply by becoming sat, eternal, you don't get ananda. That is not possible. Therefore, ananda chinmaya rasa pratibhavi tabhi, tabhi ja eva nija rupa taya kalabhi, goloko eva nivasati akhila atma bhuta, govindamadi purisam tamam vajan. So, you have to go to the anandamaya, jadgatyana nivartante, taktadi hanga punarjanunai. You have to approach in that way. Otherwise, if you remain in the material world, this will be the result. Dajjamana prajasadvi. One after another. Dajjamana. You will simply burn into ashes. Therefore, the Veda says, asatima sadgama. Don't remain here. go to Krishna and enjoy with him life. Thank you very much.